A million viruses are in a teaspoon of seawater. About 100 trillion bacteria cover the surface of your skin. Some of the most amazing life forms on Earth are too small to see with the naked eye, but equally amazing animals roam larger than life in habitats we never thought possible. Whole communities live on the ocean floor. Half the world's existing animal species and about two-thirds of existing plant species coexist in tropical rainforests, and this is just what we know so far. So how do we grapple with understanding the complex life that exists on Earth? It isn't easy. There's a lot to consider. To make it easier, scientists have developed what's known as the biological hierarchy, which breaks down the structure of living organisms on the Earth into levels. In this hierarchical organization, each higher level exists only with all of the lower levels intact. For example, if there was a pretend level that was called the sandwich level, we couldn't have a sandwich without there already existing bread and some kind of filling. So that bread and filling would be on a lower level, and the sandwich level would be a higher level. As we discuss each of the levels in the biological hierarchy, it'll be important to remember that each higher level provides novel or emergent properties that weren't found at the lower levels. This phenomenon can also be explained by the phrase, the whole is more than the sum of its parts. We'll come back to this. So let's start at the lowest level of the hierarchy. Let's start with atoms. Atoms are the smallest form of matter with distinct elemental properties. So here, let's pretend that these blue circles are oxygen atoms and that the yellow circles are hydrogen atoms. Molecules make up the next level of biological hierarchy and occur when atoms bond together. So in this case, we had two hydrogen atoms bond to an oxygen atom. Remember, this level has a new emergent set of properties. Water, H2O, has the unique property of being able to freeze as ice and be a liquid, and also to be a vapor, to be steam. And that wasn't possible for oxygen alone or for hydrogen alone. So molecules can be big or small. They can be complex and they can be simple. So let's go back to that water molecule. Again, we have one oxygen and two hydrogens. This is a pretty simple molecule, but other molecules like DNA are very complex. You can see on the right-hand side of the screen all the different atoms that make up this tremendously complex molecule. Now, just for scale, I'll put a water molecule next to this DNA molecule so you can see how small that water is compared to this big DNA molecule. One place you'll find a lot of molecules interacting together is inside cells, the next level on the biological hierarchy. Life is made up of these self-contained units. Some life is single-celled, while other life is multicellular. You yourself are made up of 10 trillion human cells. But these cells are each made up of a vast number of interacting molecules, like phospholipids, that make up our plasma membrane. Also inside cells, we have DNA. DNA, again, is that complex molecule that is made up of all different kinds of atoms, and that's housed in the nucleus of cells. So here we have the cell from the previous page, but it's interacting with other like cells in this loose connective tissue we see here. So there are a lot of different kinds of tissues in the body. This is just a schematic showing some different kinds of tissues that are present in your arm. You have epithelial tissue that makes up the skin, and you have muscle tissue in that bicep. There's nervous tissue. All these different kinds of tissues exist. Multiple tissues can associate together to perform a specific function within an organ. Different organs can work together to perform a vital function. And when you have those organs working together, we call that an organ system. So here you see the stomach working with the small and large intestines in the digestive system. Here are some examples of some organ systems that you have in the human body. So a multicellular organism will have multiple organ systems within it. Here's an example of a multicellular organism you might be familiar with, a crab. We know that organisms don't live in isolation. A group of organisms of the same species living in the same place at the same time is called a population. Groups of different species of organisms living in a shared habitat is called a community. In this case, the crabs are living together with the seaweed, fish, and jellyfish. When you include other elements of the environment, such as abiotic factors, the water, the sand, the atmosphere, the temperature, the nutrients, this is called an ecosystem. An ecosystem includes all the living organisms and non-living matter in the habitat. Now, some ecosystems around the world have generally the same kinds of abiotic and biotic components, so we call those similar ecosystems around the world biomes. In this case, you're seeing two deserts in different parts of the world. Can you tell which is in Namibia and which is in the Mojave Desert of California? It's hard to tell, right? Let's take a closer look. Not easy. In fact, the picture on the left is of the Mojave Desert, and the picture on the right is of Namibia. But these are both examples of a desert biome. So the top level of the biological hierarchy encompasses all the biomes on Earth and is called the biosphere. So let's review what we learned today, starting with the lowest level on the biological hierarchy. Atoms can bond together and form molecules, and lots of molecules will interact together in cells. Cells will associate with like cells into what we call tissues. A coming together of different kinds of tissues to perform that function is called an organ. Now, organs can associate together in organ systems, and here we're showing the digestive system. And multiple kinds of organ systems will be present in a multicellular organism. Multicellular organisms of the same type can group together in the same habitat at the same time into what we call a population. And that population can interact with other populations of other kinds of species. And once we have multiple species interacting, we call that a community. Once we add in abiotic factors like climate, again, here I'm showing water and sand, then we call that an ecosystem. And ecosystems that are similar to each other around the world are in the same biome. Now, all the biomes that exist on the planet come together in the biosphere. So this is the biological hierarchy, and it helps us understand life by organizing it into these kinds of levels. I hope this video was clear and helpful today. I look forward to seeing you in class.